Cobaletti. Dodge 1-1. Request startup.
Dodge 1-1. Cobaletti, cleared for startup. Wind 235 at 2 meters per second.
Cobaletti, Dodge 1-1. Request taxi to runway.
Alright, Dodge Flight, heads up, takeoff briefing. We're gonna go with 10 second separation, flaps maneuvering until 180 knots, and then we're gonna climb out at 5 degrees till everybody's in formation. We'll go ahead and increase our speed and continue our climb to level off at 15,000. We're gonna get above 10,000 as soon as possible, since the Georgian Intelligence Service and our intel have determined the Mad Hat attack probability is very high. So we're not going to take any chances until we get to Tbilisi. Any questions?
2-3,
no questions. 4, all clear. Good to go.
Cobaletti, Dodge 1-1. Request takeoff.
Dodge 1-1. Cobaletti? You are cleared for takeoff when ready. Climb 300 at QFE 29.82.
leads rolling. Leads gear up.
To the saddle. is in formation.
In Dodge Flight, set climb power.
Hold up, is the throttle position between full and idle?
Alright, we should be above man pad threat level at this point, but configure and arm your countermeasures and keep your eyes outside the aircraft. We're going to leave our nav lights on until we get to Tbilisi because we want to be seen by the locals. This sortie is designed to boost their morale.
Well, in that case, we should be going really low over the major cities. Nothing boosts morale like the sound of hogs' engines.
Don't forget about the sound of the gun.
I'm not sure if that would be entirely appropriate.
The Georgians wanted us to fly as low and slow as possible over as many cities and towns as we could along the way. That idea was immediately dismissed by the colonel. I believe his exact words were, "That's a damn stupid idea," because losing a hog to terrorists on the second day of the operation is not exactly his idea of boosting the locals' morale.
Can't say I disagree. That road from the port to the airfield yesterday was completely crazy.
It was indeed. Okay, let's go through the general plan for this sorting. We're going to stay above 150 until we get to waypoint 3. Then we'll start our descent. I want you guys to be extra careful at this point because this is where we're going to be the most vulnerable. The Georgians have placed patrols along our flight path, but keep that finger on that countermeasure switch. We'll check in with Rockman when we get in closer. He's going to be directing us today. We'll level out at 750 HEL over Tbilisi, and we'll try to make a good impression. Then we'll turn north, climb out to 15,000, we're going to orbit, and we're going to wait for Hunter 1-1 to rejoin. We're going to follow him to the northern part of the country, where there's big swaths that are under the de facto control of the CLA.
Who is this guy? Is he the one that's going to be briefing us?
He's a major in their intelligence service. He's our liaison with the Georgian Army throughout our deployment here.
Good, maybe give me some intel on where the good bars and clubs are.
Well, you feel free to liaise with him on that right after the sortie, okay? GIS believes that only part of the shipments go through the mountain ranges. In fact, they think the Russians are turning a blind eye on truckloads full of ammo and equipment that are going through the Roki Tunnel in South Ossetia.
Turning a blind eye or actively supporting?
Yeah, we'll ask the Georgian major later during the sortie. For now, just relax and enjoy the view.
Captain, been meaning to ask you, How's that Herc-Cry coming into Georgia?
I enjoyed every second of it. I actually spent most of the time in the pit chatting with the pilots.
Well, since you spend so much time talking to them, maybe you can answer me this. What's the 130 need four people in the pit for? I mean, I get the pilot and the co. What are the other two for?
Actually, the other three. You also have a navigator, a flight engineer, and a loadmaster.
See, that's what's been bugging me. I mean, you got two pilots in a huge pit. You got all your nav info and more on those MFDs. What the hell do you even need a nav for?
Hey, do I look like some sort of C-130 expert? I just flew in one to Georgia.
And Dodge Flight, push 142.3, standby for check-in with Beholder. Beholder, Beholder, Dodge 1-1 checking in, ASFRAC, passing waypoint 2, how copy?
Dodge 1-1, Beholder, your look is good. You're expected here at 1200 sharp. Descend to 750 feet AGL at waypoint 4, then pull up, turn left, and climb out. Orbit at waypoint 5 and rendezvous with Hunter.
And Dodge Flight copies all. We'll check in at waypoint 3 before we descend. Dodge Flight, TOT for waypoint 41200.
2:12 set.
Great, time's up.
Four.
Have to admit, country sure is beautiful.
Yeah, we'll just wait until we get over the mountains. The views there are absolutely amazing.
Oh, I've heard. It's pretty tall, right?
Yeah, they are. I think the highest peak is about 17,000 feet, somewhere near the Russian border.
That's actually pretty smart, keeping the Russians behind a huge mountain range.
Yeah, and the best thing about Georgia is Borjomi National Park. Make sure you try Borjomi mineral water if you can. It's not just famous here, but Russia too.
You seem to know a hell of a lot about this country.
Well, that would be because my wife is Armenian. We spent around 2 years in South Caucasus.
Oh, okay, cool. I won't want to pick your brain after we land then.
Coming up on waypoint 3, I'll be contacting Beholder in 5. Beholder, Dodge 1-1, checking in waypoint 3, preparing for descent.
Copy that, Dodge 1-1. Be advised, Georgian forces have secured the area below you. You should be good to go, but better keep your eyes open.
Copy.
Heads up, you have helicopters hovering at 1,000 feet AGL around 2,000 feet south and southeast from your route.
Copy. Dodge flight, descend to frag altitude, maintain formation, check countermeasures. Dodge 1-1 is at 750 feet AGL, approaching waypoint 4.
Dodge 1-1, roger. Hurry up, you're behind schedule.
Alright guys, keep your formation tight and let's do this. As well. Dodge flight's pushing to waypoint 5 and checking in with Hunter. Dodge flight's out.
That was a whole lot of people down there. Did you hear a lot cheering in the background?
This is definitely one of those places where they do want to see the U.S. troops. Yeah, but come on guys, we can act like heroes when we actually root out the terrorists. So far we haven't really done anything aside from looking good.
That's because it's not just what you do, but also how you do it that counts.
All right, let's anchor here and wait for Hunter to rejoin.
Deutsch 1-1, this is Hunter 1-1. We have a visual coming from the south at 15,000 feet.
And Hunter 1-1, Dodge 1-1, copy. Clear to join up when able.
Hunter 1-1 is information.
Roger that. We're pushing to waypoint 6. Okay, we're all ears. Looking forward to learning more about the situation.
Thank you. When we were preparing your flight plan, we decided to take you to the edge of the area which is no longer under effective Tbilisi control. And contrary to what you hear in Georgian TV channels, it's quite a big part of the country.
Don't want to panic, huh?
Of course, but I can't stress enough how much your arrival here means to us. Your 6 jets are like a whole army coming to our aid, and we need assistance. I'll be frank with you, the situation, also from the military point of view, is very bad. We've been effectively pushed out from a big part of our land. We'll get there pretty soon, a whole large area between Oni and Gritan. Everything north of that line, save for some major roads and a few settlements, is controlled by the CLA. They're claiming this area is to become a new caliphate.
Isn't that bad? You've got a regular army, helicopters, airplanes, you should be able to fight them back.
Well, in theory, yes. But the area they control is very unforgiving and difficult, with high mountains and thick forests. We also believe that the CLA is getting a constant flow of reinforcements. The battle-hardened veterans from the Chechen Wars from the north.
Flight. Go. Echelon left.
That sounds really serious. Any estimates on their numbers?
Well, as we don't have access to the territory they control, we can't tell how many have arrived. We only get sporadic data from the people that managed to escape from the new caliphate. But there is not enough info to draw a clear picture. But we know that civilians are not allowed to leave. They're also being killed, used as slaves, or worse.
What about their equipment? What do they have access to?
Well, whatever they can bring over the mountains from Chechnya. They use donkeys, so mostly light equipment, including man pests and machine guns, which they later mount on the trucks. There are rumors, however, that they managed to bring some heavy stuff as well, including APCs. With quite the constant of the Russians.
I heard they would do anything to undermine your government, but creating a new, potentially hostile entity just at their borders? I doubt it. Who knows where the CLA would strike next? If we didn't take them out, which we will, of course.
Speaking of which, do we know who their leaders are? Usually it's enough just to cut the head off the snake.
No, or several heads. We're still trying to determine who's running the whole operation. We'll share it with you once we're certain of the IDE and role played in the organization. But I agree, taking on a few high-value targets will be a crucial part of the whole campaign. Alright, if there are no more questions, so shut up for the moment and let you enjoy the views. We'll soon turn towards the mountains and main CLA hideouts north and northwest of Umburari. Alright, the area at 2 o'clock and extending north and west from there is mostly controlled by the TLA. As I mentioned, we're maintaining several checkpoints inside and also trying to patrol the outskirts. But for the moment, the goal is rather to try and keep the terrorists away from the TCT than to retake any of the land. As you can see, these are mostly highlands, mountains, and forests. The enemy is keeping the training camps and supply depots there.
So you think they might have some armored vehicles at their disposal?
They most certainly do. I think I didn't mention that we lost contact with several of our patrols and Cobras, BTR-80s and BMPs. Some probably were destroyed, but others could have, most probably were captured. There's also an issue of some of the soldiers that could have switched sides.
Whoa, could have switched sides? We're talking treason here. You mean to tell me your soldiers defected and joined the terrorists?
They have Georgian vehicles and uniforms? No telling what kind of trouble they can start.
That is why I told you that the situation was really bad. We're working on the clock to find out who the readers are and where do they operate from.
Heads up, smoke and fires on our 2 o'clock.
Leads visual. Go ahead and go sensors in on that area and we'll have a look.
This is Hunter 1-1. I can see some smoke and fire on our 2 o'clock. Can Could you have a closer look at that?
Hunter 1-1, Dodge Flight's tally, standby. Dodge 1-1's tally on a group of foot mobiles holding four people in Georgian uniforms against a wall. The Tangos are raising their weapons and taking aim. There's also an APC and Cobra close by. The gunner's wearing a Georgian uniform but is also aiming at the soldiers. They started shooting. This is an execution.
The bastards! Do you see any other forces in the area?
Couple of SUVs and some trucks, and there's some more foot mobiles with rifles.
White Waddle has been contacting my superiors.
Wait one, contacting Overlord. Overlord, Dodge 1-1. Dodge 1-1 is tally on a large group of Tangos setting fire to civilian buildings at grid 3-8 Tango, Kilo November 944452. They just executed four Georgian soldiers. We're requesting permission to engage.
Dodge 1-1, Overlord, copy your last. Tango's at grid, Kilo November 944452. Standby.
Dodge 1-1, standing by.
Overlord, you are cleared hot. I repeat, cleared hot.
Dodge 1-1 copies, cleared hot. Hunter 1-1, Dodge Flight. Go find a shady spot with a good view. Dodge Flight's in hot.
Hunter 1-1, understood. Take out that APC first. I'd rather see it destroyed than used by the CLA against us.
Copy.
flight. Engage targets of opportunity.
Two.
3, join up.
3, rejoin.
Dodge 1-1, we are off the target, back at the IP. All targets in the area splashed.
Dodge 1-1, Overlord. Roger that, you are cleared to RTV.
Hunter, Dodge. Enemy units in that area destroyed. We're at the end of our roll time. We are RTV.
Roger. It was an incredible show. I think we should make the recordings public. Okay, we're turning back to Vazeni now. I'll arrive in Kabul late in the evening and should be joining most of your briefings from now on.
Copy all, Hunter. We'll see you. Dodge 1-1 flight, push, FM.
Join up.
Did y'all see what happened? These poor guys were cut in half by that machine gun fire.
Yeah, I saw it. It was personal before because they shot at my plane. Now they definitely crossed the line. One, put me on the roster for the next 20. Can't wait to smoke these bastards some more.
We'll talk about the flying schedule when we get back.
Well, this is going to be a long debrief. Alright, people, let's head home. Maintain radio silence till we're over the base. Leads out.
flight. Go, echelon right. Cavaletti, Dodge 1-1, inbound.
Dodge 1-1, Cavaletti, fly heading 153, 46, QFE 29.82, runway 25, to pattern altitude.
Cavaletti, Dodge 1-1, request landing.
Dodge 1-1, Cavaletti, clear to land, runway 25, wind 235 at 2 meters per second.
Flight, RTB.